Let us start today's session with the ampere circuit law, which is lecture number 6. So in the last class you have come across Biot-Savart's law, where magnetic field intensity can be written as I into dl cross air cap divided by 4 pi r square. Okay, field intensity due to current element we have found for finite and infinite current element. Okay, further we'll move on to finding the magnetic field intensity using this Ampere's circuital law. So what this Ampere's circuital law states? It states that line integral of magnetic field intensity H vector about any closed path is equal to direct current enclosed by that path. Okay, that is, so if you consider there is a current element which is something like this, a thin filament. Okay, the field intensity, the line integral of field intensity around a closed path will be nothing but it encloses a current. Okay, that means if you have a current element like this, the field intensity, line integral of field intensity around the closed path will be equal, it encloses the this current. Okay, so line integral of H dot dl will be equal to current enclosed here. Let us consider the current enclosed is nothing but I. Okay, line integral H dot dl equal to I is nothing but Ampere's circuital law. Okay, it must be any closed path. It can be in any shape, but it should be a closed path. So we'll take the first problem. Determine the magnetic field intensity both inside and outside of the conductor of radius a, small a, meters. The conductor carries a current of I amperes using Ampere's law. Okay, so whatever you have tried to do in the last session, that is about finding field intensity using Biot-Savart's law, now we are trying to find out the field intensity using Ampere's law. Okay, so what it tells, so let us consider this field due to this conductor of radius a. Let us try to find out the field intensity inside the conductor and outside the conductor. Okay, so let us take for radius rho less than a, that means inside the conductor. So then we have to find out something called current density, which is nothing but J equal to I by pi a square. Okay, so which results as magnetic field intensity will be nothing but H into dl. H into dl integral is nothing but dl over a closed path. If you take a closed path, it will be nothing but 2 pi rho, which will be equal to this current density multiplied by the area. So current density is I divided by pi a square multiplied by the area is nothing but pi rho square. Okay, so hence the field intensity by doing this cross multiplying and simplifying, H vector will become I into rho by 2 pi a square a phi cap. Okay, so this is the field intensity inside the conductor. If you take outside the conductor, that is a second case, for rho greater than a, the field intensity is H dot dl over a line integral will be equal to current enclosed. It encloses the full current, so it is nothing but I. In the previous one, it will not enclose the full current. So because it is, it may enclose a part of the current inside, we have considered here current density. But here, when you move outside, it encloses the full current, so it is I. So it is nothing but H I H into 2 pi rho equal to I, or nothing but H equal to I by 2 pi rho. So this is the same solution what we have got in the last session for an infinite current carrying conductor. Here it is H vector equal to I by 2 pi rho into A phi cap ampere per meter. Consider the second problem. Using Ampere's law, derive an expression for magnetic field intensity at all points in a coaxial cable and also plot it. Consider the closed path of radius rho. So let us consider here coaxial cable. Coaxial cable here is, this is nothing but inner conductor may be having a radius a, and this is the outer conductor. The outer conductor inside, it is radius b. Outermost one, the cylinder is the radius c. Okay, inside conductor maybe current is flowing in this direction. In outside conductor, the current flowing in the opposite direction with respect to inside conductor. Okay, so one is flowing in this direction, other is flowing in the opposite direction. Okay, So we have to find out the field intensity inside the inner conductor, in between these two conductor, and inside the outer conductor, and outside this coaxial cable. Okay. So first we'll try to find out for rho less than A. Okay, the first case for rho less than A, inside this inner conductor. Okay. So what it becomes? The what is the current enclosed here? It will be part of the current I. Okay. So we have to consider the current density. So it becomes H into 2 pi rho will be equal to I into pi rho square current density I by pi a square into area pi rho square. Okay. So H will be equal to I rho divided by 2 pi a square. It is same as this one. Okay. It is same as this one. But let us move for rho greater than A but less than B. So in the second case, A is less than rho, less than B. So rho is greater than A and less than B. So what is the current enclosed? It is the total current I. That means we are present somewhere here where it is greater than A but less than B. This is B and this one is A. We are between A to B. So this is the place where it encloses this full inner conductor current. So it will be equal to I divided by 2 pi rho, the field intensity. Okay. Next part C is for rho between B to C. Okay, what is rho between B to C? Where the current line integral H dot dl is nothing but I minus J dot ds. That means it encloses, if you consider the point somewhere here, it encloses this full current and part of this current flowing in this conductor in the reverse direction. So, okay, so it is I minus integral surface integral J dot ds. Okay. So H dot dl is nothing but same H into 2 pi rho, which is equal to I minus J multiplied by this pi rho square minus pi b square. Okay. So then what is J? J is nothing but this I divided by pi into C square minus b square. This is J. Okay. So by substituting that, we get H equal to I by 2 pi rho into this. Okay. So with these three cases, we have got H in the inside inner and outer conductor and in between the conductors. Okay. So let us consider here outside point. Okay. If you take outside point, then what happens? It is the total current I in this direction and the current in the opposite direction. So it becomes I minus I. If you take a point outside this coaxial cable, then the current, the field intensity will become zero. Okay. So H dot dl is nothing but I minus I, implies H will be equal to zero. Okay. So we are trying to plot it here. Over a radius of A, the field intensity is increasing. Then between A to B, it is decreasing. Again, B to C, it is further decreasing. Okay. At C, it reaches zero. That is outside the cable. Further, we'll consider one more problem, that is express the value of H vector in rectangular components at point P with coordinate 0.20 in the field of a current filament 2.5 amps in AZ cap direction at X equal to 0.1 and Y equal to 0.3. Okay. So we have to find out the field intensity in rectangular components, that is in Cartesian coordinate system, at some point P, and where the current element is carrying 2.5 amps in AZ cap direction, and we have to find out where the this conductor is passing through a point X equal to 0.1, Y equal to 0.3. That means if you take anywhere in this conductor, the coordinates will be, it is 0.1 comma 0.3 comma some Z. So we'll find out this magnetic field intensity, which is nothing but I by 2 pi rho into A phi cap. What is A phi cap? It is current cross product with the unit vector. Okay. So current direction is AZ cap. So what is this unit vector? It is nothing but if you take a point P here and the conductor here, it will become 0 minus 0.1. So minus 0.1 AX cap, and then 0.2 minus 0.3, it will become minus 0.1 AY cap, and 0 minus 0 AZ cap. Okay. So you will have X component and some Y component. So So this gives you a unit vector AR cap. So using this, you can also find out the radial row. Length radial row is nothing but this magnitude, so which gives you 0.1 into root 2. Okay, the total field intensity is substituting this unit vector and this row value here, it gives you this answer as 1.199 a x cap minus 1.99 a y. Further, we also have to perform this cross product, that is this z cross this unit vector, that is this unit vector. So z cross x is nothing but y, and z cross y is nothing but minus ax cap. So you have x component and a y component. Let us take one more fifth problem. A coaxial cable centered on z axis with radius a 0.3 and b 0.5 and c 0.6 and current I is 2.5 amp in az direction in center conductor. Okay, so we'll see, you know, since point P is inside, okay, see, first let us find out the field intensity inside this P. Okay, since point P is inside, we know already field intensity can be written as I rho divided by 2 pi a square. Okay, what is rho? Rho is nothing but 0.2. suppose if this value is given, which is equal to 0.2, then we can substitute that a is nothing but 0.3. it is given here. By substituting that, H vector gives us this. Okay. So we'll consider one important thing here, that is a solenoid. Okay, there is a tubular solenoid of radius r meter is wound with n turns and carries a current of I amperes. Derive an expression for magnetic field intensity anywhere on x axis. Part A, part B is at center of solenoid and part C is at one end of the solenoid, using Cartesian coordinate system. Okay, what is solenoid? Solenoid is nothing but you have a tube. Okay, on the tube some wires will be wound on this, so you have n number of turns on that tubular, okay, tube. Okay, that is called as a solenoid. Okay, so due to this element where it is having n tons of filaments, we have to find out the magnetic field intensity. Okay, how to go about? We'll consider here, if there are n turns here on this conductor, let us consider a point P here, okay, which is at a depth of z from this beginning of the tube. Okay, and let us consider this is having a radius of r. Okay, this filament, this silk tube. Okay, and at some point P, we have to find out the magnetic field intensity. Okay, so over any one turn, we'll take a differential length. Okay, over one turn, we'll take a differential length. The point on the differential length, let me take a point C on a differential length. The differential length point is coordinates are 0, comma r comma minus z. Suppose that point P is below this point P, let me take it as minus z. Then this I've told, solenoid is a coil wound in a tightly packed helix. Okay, it will be normally used in car starters, railroads, frequency as electric switch. Now consider the length of the tubular solenoid as L meters. Okay, this length of this tube, which is in a cylinder, it is L meters. Okay, and the number of turns per meter will be nothing but N by L. Okay, consider a differential length dz. Okay, on the thin filament on one circle, consider a element length as dz. So it will become N by L into dz turns. So what is differential field intensity from using Biot-Savart's law? dH vector can be written as I into dl cross ar divided by 4 pi r square. Since you have number of turns, due to all those, it will be N by L into dz. Okay, this is the differential field. Okay, which will be equal to further I into dl into current flowing. Let us consider it is in minus ax cap direction divided by this. R square is nothing but R square plus Z square, and unit vector, once you get the vector, it is R A Y plus Z A Z cap. We can find out this magnitude. Okay, So further, by substituting these things, unit vector and the magnitude, we get something like this. Okay, but this is the differential magnetic field intensity. What we have to find here is the total magnetic field intensity. So from the figure, we'll have the tan theta. Okay, if you take at point P the angle theta, if you take at point P, this is the angle theta. It is nothing but tan theta will be nothing but this opposite. This opposite is nothing but this length. Okay, divided by this length. This length will be this tan theta. Tan theta is nothing but radius r divided by the radius r divided by the height z. Okay, this is radius r of the tubular solenoid, and this height is z. So tan theta is r divided by z. So z will be equal to r into cot theta. So dz is nothing but this. By substituting that and the differential magnetic field intensity further, and then simplifying it, it becomes sine theta, and then integrating from theta 1 to theta 2, that is from some initial point to final point, we get something like this, ni by 2l into cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. Now we'll take a part B. If point P is on the center of the solenoid, if it is on the center, so what will this will be simplified as? The theta 1 and theta 2 angle, the theta 1 will become, by this figure, this theta 1 will become 180 minus theta 2, okay, where h vector will become ni by 2l cos theta 2 minus cos theta 1. Theta 1 is 180 minus theta 2, it will become cos theta 2, okay, further simplifying this, okay, where cos theta 2 from this figure can be calculated as adjacent length l by 2 divided by this hypotenuse, okay. If r, the radius r is much less than length l, then cos theta 2 will be equal to l by 2 by l by 2, which is equal to 2. So h vector will be only ni by l. But if this point P at one end of the conductor, then theta 1, this theta 1 is this whole angle which will become 90 degree. So it will become only ni by 2 l cos theta 2. Okay. Further, similarly, if you take at some other one more n, it may become some other angle cos theta 3, where theta cos theta 3 is written as l divided by root of l square plus r square. Okay, further we'll move take one more problem. Using Ampere's law, determine the magnetic field intensity due to toroid. Okay, toroid is nothing but a circular solenoid. Okay, it, instead of having a tubular shape, you have a ring shaped, okay, on that ring the wire will be wound, number of turns will be there, okay. So due to this we have to find out the magnetic field intensity, okay. So it is very simple using Ampere's law. Ampere's law states that line integral of h dot dl will be equal to n into I, okay. So which will be equal to h into 2 pi rho is equal to ni. So that is h will be equal to ni by 2 pi rho. Instead of writing I here, the current is flowing through n number of turns. So it is n into I. So h will be equal to ni by 2 pi rho. It is as simple as that. So now I'll move on to the one important thing, that is curl. Okay. So what is curl? We'll see what is this curl and how to apply the magnetic curl on a magnetic field intensity. Okay. The curl of any vector point function gives the measure of the angular velocity at any point of the vector field. Okay, this curl gives the measure of angular velocity. Any motion in which the curl of the velocity vector is zero, it is said to be irrotational. Okay, if you are trying to find the curl of a velocity and the answer is zero, it is called irrotational. Okay, otherwise it is rotational. Okay, so normally this curl is nothing but the measure of the angular velocity. The Ampere's law in integral form, we know that it is line integral of h dot dl, okay, which is equal to I. Okay, let us consider if it is equal to differential a small current, then line integral h dot dl is nothing but delta I, okay, over a closed path. If you divide on both the sides by the differential surface area, and where this surface area is tending to 0, then this can be re-expressed as limit delta s tending to 0. This line integral h dot dl divided by delta s equal to limit delta s tending to 0 delta I divided by delta s. Okay. Or from the mathematical definition, this left hand side is nothing but curl h. Okay. Curl is denoted by del cross. Okay. So this whole thing is nothing but del cross h, which is equal to limit delta s tending to 0 line integral h dot dl divided by delta s. Okay. So this is nothing but curl h. So what is curl h? Is this LHS is nothing but curl h. So what is curl h? Is resulting it as current divided by surface area. What is current divided by surface area? It is nothing but current density. Okay. So curl of magnetic field intensity results in current density. So this is a very important result. The curl of magnetic field intensity is nothing but current density J vector. Okay. So we can state here this as one of the Maxwell's equation. The curl of magnetic field intensity is nothing but J vector. Okay. Whereas we know what is line integral of E dot dl, which will be resulting as 0. Okay. So if you take a curl on electric field intensity, because this line integral is 0, the answer will be here. Here the curl of electric field intensity will be resulting it as 0. Okay. That means this is considered the second Maxwell's equation, that is curl of H equal to J vector. And similarly, but if you take curl on electric field intensity, it will be equal to 0. Okay. These are the two important results. And curl H is actually expressed as curl of H, del cross H is written as, on the first line, you can write in a determinant form. On the first row, we can express the unit vectors. In the second row, it is dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z. And in the third row, we'll be writing the magnetic field intensity, X component, Y component, and the Z component. Okay. So this is in the Cartesian form. Similarly, the cylindrical form curl H is written as 1 by rho into determinant of A rho, rho into A phi, A z cap. And then dou by dou rho, dou by dou phi, dou by dou z. In the third row, it is rho component, rho into phi component, and z component. Okay. In spherical coordinate system, this curl of magnetic field intensity is expressed as 1 by r square sine theta. In the first row, it is A r cap, r into a theta cap, and r sin theta a phi cap. Then it is dou by dou rho, dou by dou theta, dou by dou phi. Then it is hr, r into h theta, r sin theta h phi. Okay. So we have to remember now the curl of magnetic field intensity in Cartesian, cylindrical form, and spherical form. Okay. So further, by using this, we'll try to solve few problems. Okay. So first problem in this: given the magnetic field intensity H vector equal to 0.2 Z square AX cap for Z greater than 0. And for Z greater than D by 2, it is the magnetic field intensity is 0 elsewhere. Okay. Calculate the magnetic field intensity H dot dl over a closed path about a square wire with side D centered at 0, 0, z in the y equal to 0 plane, and also find curl of magnetic field intensity. Okay. So that has been shown in this figure. Okay. So what is given here is there is a square path. Okay. It is centered at 0, 0, z. Okay. And it is there in y plane. Okay. That means the current is flowing along X direction, and the current may be flowing in the Z direction. So we have to find out the magnetic field intensity H dot dl vector. Okay. Okay. But here H vector is given as 0.2 Z square into AX cap. Okay. Means only X component is there. So once if we try to find this closed path, so along x direction only we have to consider, but we can't consider along the z direction because there is no field intensity along the z direction. So we have to do integration over this filament and integration over this filament. Okay. So line integral of h dot dl is nothing but 0.2 z square. Okay. So what is that z? That z is nothing, z square is nothing but z I z plus half into d whole square. Okay. Because this length from this this point to here. Okay. So you have a current filament. This point is 0, 0, z. So this length is nothing but half d. Okay, because this length is d, this total length from here to here, half of that is nothing but half d. Okay, so it becomes from here to here it is z. So this length is nothing but half d. So it will become z plus half d whole square multiplied by this length. This element length is nothing but d. Okay. So if you take one side it is nothing but this length is d and this length will be half d. Okay, whereas one more side it will become z minus half d. Okay, because it is on the next element, this length will be here to here, this is z. Okay, here to here it is z, this length is half d. Okay, for the second element this length is z, so you have to do minus half d, so it will become this length will become z minus of d. This length will be now z minus of d. Okay, so it is z minus of d whole square into length of the conductor, again it is d. Okay, so you have this thin filament like this. This is the point p 0, 0, z. This filament, it is there in the xz plane. Okay, it is there in the xz plane. Okay, this is x axis and this one is x axis and z axis. If you consider, this is nothing but thin filament which is in the form of a square loop. Okay. So by doing this h dot dl, we get these two terms along z direction. There is no field intensity, so it is zero here, zero here. Okay. So this is, we got answer, we will get the answer as 0.4 z 1 into d square amperes. Okay. Further, we'll try to find out what is curl of magnetic field intensity, which will be equal to, by using substituting directly in the Cartesian form, since there is only x component, it is 0.2 z square in the problem, y component is 0 in the question and z component is 0. So by finding this determinant, we get curl of magnetic field intensity as 0.4 z ay cap ampere per meter square. Okay, further we'll take one more problem. It is evaluate the closed line integral of h vector about the rectangular path point p1 p2 p3 p4. Okay, the coordinates of p1 p2 p3 p4 are given. Determine the quotient of enclosed line integral and the area enclosed by the path as an approximation to curl h, a component y. Okay, we'll try to do this first. Okay, so first thing is we'll find out the line integral of h dot dl. Okay, so what is this h vector is given? The h vector, yeah, here it is given as 3z ax cap minus 2x cube az cap. Okay, this is the magnetic field intensity given in the problem. Okay, so we have to find out this magnetic field intensity over a differential length integral. Okay, so first thing is we have to move from point p1 to p2. Okay, we have to move from point p1 to p2, then let us take p1 to p2, then it is p2 to p3, then 3 to 4, then 4 back to 1. Okay, so if you are moving p1 to p2, I have taken here this as x axis, this as z axis. Okay, throughout this is there in y equal to 3 plane, that this rectangular shape conductor, it is there in a y equal to 3 plane. Okay. So we have to when we are moving from p1 to p2, we are changing the x value. Okay, x value is changing from 2 to 4 in the point p1 to p2. Okay, so we have to do this 3z into dx. This is the field intensity multiplied by the differential length. Differential length is nothing but here dx ax cap. Okay, so it is dz into x. Okay, dx integration is nothing but x, limit is from P1 to P2, which is nothing but it is we are moving from 2 to 4. Okay, so it is 4 minus 2. Then this we have to integrate 2x cube with respect to z. Okay, so this will become a constant. Dz integration is z in this direction, P2 to P3. Here we are moving from P2 to P3 in z direction. So it is nothing but we are moving from 4 to P2 to P3. Okay, so we are moving from 4 to 1. Okay, so it will become 4 minus 1. Further, along this direction, that is from P3 to P4, further we have to do P3 to P4, again it is dx, and over dx now we will be moving from, before it was moving from 4 to 2, now we will be moving from 2 to 4. Okay, that's why here it is written as minus. Okay, then in the last direction, here along z direction, again we will be moving from 1 to 4, so it is 4 minus 1. Okay, so by substituting these calculation, we get it as 354 amperes. Okay, so we are not doing anything much. Along this direction it is dx component, along this direction it is dz component. Okay, so part B is we have to find out curl H at a, as a component of Y. It can be calculated as limit the length tending to 0, line integral h dot dl divided by dx into dz. Okay, so already we have got in the previous part A line integral h dot dl, which is equal to 354. Okay, divided by the length dx into dz, which will be equal to 2 into 3. Okay, this length, it is nothing but this length, this x length and this z length. Okay, so it is nothing but 2 and 3. Okay, by substituting that we get it as 59 ampere per meter square, because curl of magnetic field intensity gives current density. Okay, this is a approximate calculation. One more way of finding this curl H is by writing this in the determinant form and substituting that x component, y component and z component and finding this determinant. So doing that, we get it as curl of H, we get it as 6x cube plus 3 at point P. What is point P? That is at the center. If you tried finding the point P at the center, x is nothing but 3. So it will become 6 into 3 square plus 3, which gives you 57 ampere per meter square. So we can see here it is 59, the approximate value. The actual value will be 57. It is almost near. Let me take one more problem, that is calculate the value of vector current density, that is J vector, in a rectangular coordinates at point P, it is 2, 3, 4. If H vector is given in this manner, first let us find out this problem, which is there in the Cartesian coordinate system. Okay. So that is J vector is nothing but curl H, okay, which is equal to ax, ay, az cap, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by z. Then it is the components of h, it is x component, here it is 0, and y component is x square into z, and z component is y square into x, okay, minus y square x, that has been substituted. Then we just have to find the determinant. It is straightforward, ax cap into dou by dou y of this minus dou by dou z of this, okay, minus ay cap into dou by dou x of minus y square x and dou by dou z of 0. Dou by dou z of 0 is 0 here, okay. Az cap dou by dou x of x square z, we get it as 2xz, but dou by dou y of 0 is nothing but 0 here, okay. By doing this determinant, we get minus of 2xy plus x square ax cap plus y square ay cap plus 2xz az cap, okay. Then what is this current density at point P? Point P coordinates are 2, 3 and 4, okay. By substituting x, y, z as 2, 3, 4, by doing it here, we get current density at point P as minus 16 ax cap plus 9 ay cap plus 16 az cap ampere per meter square. So by finding this determinant method, That is, for the curl of magnetic field intensity, we can get the current density. Okay. Further, part B in this problem, H vector is equal to 2 by rho cos of 0.25 arrow cap at point P, we have to find out. Okay. So this is the problem in cylindrical coordinate system. So here the current density is nothing but curl of magnetic field intensity. It is 1 by rho arrow cap rho a phi az cap dou by dou rho dou by dou phi dou by dou z. Then it is rho component rho into phi component and the z component. Okay. So here it becomes 1 by rho into rho rho a phi az dou by dou rho dou by dou phi dou by dou z. Okay. And in the problem, what are the components given? Only rho component is there. There is no phi component and there is no z component. Okay. Hence it becomes only rho component is 2 by rho cos of, what is there here? Cos of 0.25 and 0 and 0. Okay. So then it becomes arrow cap. Will become 0, rho into a phi cap dou by dou rho and dou by dou phi, only this is possible, and az cap dou by dou rho dou by dou phi is possible, but rho a phi into dou by dou rho is 0, dou by dou z, there is no z here, it is 0, so only we get it as az component. Okay, so and then differentiating with respect to phi, this cos 0.25, it comes as something like this, j at point P, substituting for rho value and phi value, we get the answer as 0.05 az cap. Okay. So this is just a direct substitution after doing a differentiation and then, I mean, by finding this determinant. Okay. Further, in this part C is magnetic field intensity H vector is I by sin theta into A theta cap at point P. Okay. So, in this, we have to find out the magnetic field intensity, that is curl H. Okay. So, in this problem, only the theta component has been given. Okay. R component is 0 and phi component is 0. Okay. So, what one thing has to be focused here is writing this curl of H in the spherical coordinate system properly, that is 1 by r square sin theta ar cap r into a theta cap r sin theta into a phi cap. Okay, it is dou by dou r, dou by dou theta and dou by dou phi. It is hr r into h theta into r into sin theta h phi. Okay, so what it becomes, ar cap dou by dou theta of 0, it is 0, dou by dou phi of this, again here it becomes, what is that, h theta is nothing but 1 by sin theta into r. So, it becomes r by sin theta. Dou by dou phi of this also it is 0. Okay. Then r a theta cap into dou by dou r of 0. It is 0. Dou by dou phi of 0 it is 0. Only remaining now it is r sin theta into a phi cap. So, we have r sin theta into a phi cap. Dou by dou r of this minus dou by dou theta of 0. Minus dou by dou theta of 0 is 0. So, it is only dou by dou r of this. So, it becomes only 1 by sin theta. Okay. So, r sin theta into a phi cap into 1 by sin theta multiplied by this 1 by r square sin theta. So, which will result as 1 by r sin theta. Okay. What is point P is given? So, we have to find out the field intensity at point P. Point P coordinates are 2, 30 degree, 20 degree. Okay. So, what is theta now? It is R, theta and phi. Theta is nothing but 30 degree. Okay. Hence, the current density at point P will become 1 divided by 2 into sine theta is nothing but 30 degree. By substituting that, we get it as current at point P, current density at point P will become 1 into a phi cap ampere per meter square. Okay. So, what one thing has to be remembered in this particular session is One is all about this ampere circuital law and all about the curl. Okay, so the one important thing here is finding the curl of magnetic field intensity, where curl of magnetic field intensity is nothing but curl H, okay, which is written as del cross H. Okay, remembering this del cross H is nothing but current density. Okay, so you have to remember the curl, expressing the curl in Cartesian form, curl in cylindrical form, and curl in the spherical form. These three forms, standard forms, has to be focused, and you all have to remember this, so that whenever the problem is asked on finding the magnetic field, the current density, by knowing the magnetic field intensity, we just have to substitute this XYZ component, that is the Cartesian components. Or if the problem, if it is in cylindrical, then you have to find rho, phi, and z component. Okay, extra here it is rho. This has to be, it should be taken care of. Here also one rho is there. Here it is 1/rho is there. These things has to be taken care. In spherical coordinate system, it is 1/r² sin theta. Then here r is there. Here r is there. And with respect to phi component, it is r sin theta, r sin theta is there. Okay, so these things should be reproduced properly so that you will get the right answer. Okay, so one, what we have come across here is, one is all about the ampere circuital law, that is line integral of magnetic field intensity, line integral of H dot dl is equal to current. That is one thing. And second thing, what you have come across here, it is all about curl of magnetic field intensity, which is also considered as Maxwell's equation. Okay, where curl of H vector gives you current density, whereas curl of electric field intensity gives you equal to zero. Okay, these statements are true only for static electric field intensity or steady magnetic field intensity. Okay, whereas these equations will change when you consider the time varying field intensity. So that you take a time varying electric field as well as time varying magnetic field intensity, these equations will change. Okay, but these things are true for steady magnetic field intensity and the electrostatic field. Okay, steady magnetic field intensity in the sense, it is due to DC current. Okay, it is due to direct current. Okay, further in the next module 4, you will be studying, or you will be learning about time varying field. There these two equations will be going to change, that is curl of H and curl of E. You will be having further few extra terms along with this J, and curl E is not equal to zero for time varying fields. So here you have come across finding the curl of H vector. It is nothing but curl of H is nothing but J vector. Okay. So I'll stop at this point. What you have come across is all about curl of magnetic field intensity. Oh, that is one thing, and also about the Ampere's circuital law. Okay, further we'll discuss more about this magnetic field intensity, something about Stokes' theorem, something similar to Gauss' law, what you have come across for electrostatic fields. We'll see for magnetic field intensity, something known as Stokes' theorem, in the next session.